Good morning, dear. I wish you are all healthy and fine. Today, we will talk about different ways to prove and how to calculate the area and perimeter of the triangle. It's the last session about explanation, and after that, we will start solving exercises from our book. Ways to prove. How to prove an isosceles triangle? One of the following conditions is sufficient to prove that a triangle is isosceles. We know as a definition that an isosceles triangle has two equal sides, two equal angles, the base angles, and the median is at the same time height bisector and perpendicular bisector, which median issued from the main vertex. So, if we have given two equal sides or two equal angles, or we proved in the parts before that median is at the same time a height or bisector or perpendicular bisector, so we can conclude that our triangle is isosceles. An equilateral triangle is a triangle that has three equal sides and three equal angles, each one of them equals to 60 degrees. We know that from the definition. So, if we have given or proved in the previous parts that the three sides of the triangle are equal or the three angles are equal, each one of them is 60 degrees, or the median issued from any vertex. When we talk about an isosceles triangle, the median issued from the main vertex is at the same time height bisector and perpendicular bisector. But in equilateral triangle, a median issued from any vertex is at the same time a height bisector and perpendicular bisector. Why? Since the three angles are equal. So, if we have three equal sides or three equal angles, each one of them is 60, or a median is at the same time height bisector and perpendicular bisector, we can say that our triangle is an equilateral triangle. Another way to prove, we know that isosceles triangle has two equal angles. Okay, if we proved that an isosceles triangle and one of its angles is 60 degrees, so this isosceles triangle is particularly an equilateral triangle. Okay? Now, a right triangle. A right triangle has one right angle, and the side facing the right angle is called a hypotenuse. Okay, we know that from the definition. So, if we proved that we have or a given one right angle and two perpendicular sides, or two complementary angles, I mean the sum of angles is 90 degrees, or the median relative to the hypotenuse is equal to its half. Hypotenuse is the side facing the right angle. The median issued from the vertex of the right angle to the midpoint of the hypotenuse, okay, so it's equal to its half, then I can say any one of these four conditions tell me that the triangle is right. What about right isosceles triangle? If our triangle is isosceles and we have one right angle, so simply it's a right isosceles. It's right since it has a right angle, and isosceles since it has two equal sides or two equal angles. So we can start from isosceles and prove that it's right isosceles triangle by having a right angle, or if a right triangle has two equal sides or two equal angles, this means that it's a right isosceles triangle. A semilateral triangle is the easiest one. It's a triangle that has 30, 60, and 90 degrees. Let's talk now about area and perimeter. Perimeter of a triangle is the sum of the length of its three sides. Note that the three sides must be expressed in the same unit. From the previous years, we know that the perimeter of a polygon is the sum of its length. Now, when we have this triangle, for example, I have to add the length of the first side with the length of the second side and the length of the third side. Okay, that's how we calculate the perimeter of a triangle. If we have an equilateral triangle, equilateral means the three sides are equal. If here, for example, the length of side is given as I, unknown, or X, or M, or whatever. So, I have to say it's I plus I plus I, or simply 3 times I. That's an equilateral triangle. In isosceles triangle, we have two equal sides and a base. How to find the perimeter? It's the base plus the length of the two sides, or 2i plus b. Or for simplicity, we can say it's I plus I plus b. A scalene triangle, I told you before, it's a triangle that doesn't have equal sides. Okay? So here, if this side length is a, b, and c, so the perimeter is a plus b plus c. We have to calculate the perimeter of triangle ABC. Given that AB equal 3 cm, AC equal 3 cm, and BC equal 3 cm. The first thing we have to look at the unit. The three sides have the same unit, so I can add them. Perimeter is the sum of length of the sides. So it's AB plus BC plus CA. So it's a 3 plus 4 plus 3 equals to 10 centimeter. Another triangle, PMN, PM equal 12 meter, MN equal 5 meter, and PN equal to 9 meter. Here, the three sides have the same length, so simply I have to add them to find the perimeter. It's MN plus NP plus PM, so 5 plus 9 plus 12 equal to 26 meter, and we have to write the unit. It's very important to write the unit. The area, as a definition, the area of triangle is equal to the half of the product of base and the corresponding height. It's a rule that we should memorize, that the area of triangle is base times height over 2. It's so important, we have to keep it in your mind. Here, for example, we have triangle ABC. This is AH, the height relative to BC. And the base here is BC. How to find the area? It's height times base over 2. In an acute triangle, the height AH is inside the triangle and the base is BC. So the area of triangle is ABC is height times base over 2. So AH times BC over 2. In a right triangle, we have a right angle, so these are perpendicular. FE is perpendicular to EG. FE is the height and EG is the base. So the area of the triangle is height times base over 2. It's EF times EG over 2. In an obtuse triangle, we talk about it when we discussed the height. The height is outside the triangle. We can't draw perpendicular and to NP and find it inside the triangle. So the height is outside the triangle. The height is MK and the base is just NP. So the height is, the area is height times base over 2. So it's NP times MK over 2. Note that any median in a triangle divides the triangle into two triangles of the same area, of course, because the median issued from the vertex to the midpoint of the opposite side, so it divides the triangle into two triangles of the same area. Now, ABC is a triangle where AH, this is triangle ABC, AH is the height, so AH is perpendicular to BC, and AM is the median, so M is the midpoint of BC. I have to prove that triangles AMB, this triangle in light pink, and the triangles A and C have the same area. What's the area of the triangle? It's height times base over 2. In triangle ABM here, the height is AH and the base is BM. So the area is AH times BM over 2. Height times base over 2. What about the triangle AMC? The rule is height times base over 2. Since it's an obvious triangle, it has an obvious angle here. So the height is AH and the base is MC. Okay, I'm talking about the triangle AMC. So height times base over 2, height is AH, base is MC, so it's AH times MC over 2. But look, I have to prove that area of AMB equals to area of AMC. AH is the height, it's the same in the two expressions. Here we have MB and MC. Can we prove that MB equal to MC to say that the areas are equal? Here is MB and MC. Since AM is the median, so directly I can say that M is the midpoint of BC, so definitely BM equal to MC. Since AH is the same and MB equal to MC, now I can say that the area of AMB equals to area of AMC. Thank you for your attention.